Hello and welcome to the first video on Mudra YouTube channel. I'm Ujwal and today I will be showing you some inspiration using the beautiful Peony Bouquet stamp set. Mudra stamps are designed and manufactured in India. They are deeply etched and machine cut, so they are really neat and the stamping is very crisp. Also, the sets have been put together after a lot of thought and discussion, and that means that the elements in a set go really well together and offer a lot of possibilities for all kinds of different cuts. Another important thing to note is the packaging. The packaging is quite different from what we normally get for stamps. It is sturdier and reusable, and that means you won't have to buy stamp pockets or store the stamps in Ziplocs anymore. It has a flap for the closure, so the stamps won't fall out even if they are stored upside down. And there is a latch on the back to keep the flap in place. Also, the plastic is softer and thicker, and that means it wouldn't crack or tear, so you can use this packaging for a really long time. I'm really excited about this release, and it was the first release of Mudra, and we will be having a new release every 15th of every month. So I'm really looking forward to that. For today's card, I'm using the Fabriano L Air cardstock. It's 220 GSM, smooth on one side and textured on the other, and I'll be using the textured side. Now I'm using the long stem peony, and you can see the stem of the flower is straight, but I'm going to go ahead and curve it a little with my hand while mounting on the block. That is the beauty of clear stamps. You can manipulate them a little while working with them. So now I'm using Archival Black Ink and stamping the flower on my white piece of cardstock that I'm using. It's called Pinaco. And you can see I missed a little spot there while stamping, but that's okay. I'll fix it later. For the second flower, I curved the stem to the other side so that I have a little variation. And I stamped that as well. Now I'm using my regular pilot pen to fix the spot that I missed while stamping, and it's really easy to do. Also, I mentioned this clean sham cloth for cleaning your stamps. Tejal from Creative Expressions recommended this, and she has a description of it on her blog, and I really like this product. It cleans up the stamps really well, and you can see mine is so dirty, but it still cleans like a charm. All you have to do is just moisten it a little, keep it moistened, it leaves no fuzz behind, and it's really cool. So I just keep it in a plastic container. I hydrate it every once in a while, and it's ready for me all the time. So now that I have my flowers stamped, I'm going to use the water soluble oil pastels. I got these from Amazon, and they are similar to, I would say, distress crayons or gelatos. They have similar kind of a texture, or prima oil pastels. But I cannot compare all these different brands because I haven't used all of them. But I am really excited about these. These have a very creamy, soft texture, and they are very smooth on the paper. So you'll see me coloring the flowers with these, and you can blend them with your finger. And they are, since they are water soluble, you can also add a little bit of water to them and use them as watercolors. They won't be as blendable as watercolors, but they really work and they leave some really cool texture behind. So I'm just using a red color and loosely coloring the flowers here, and then I'm going to take my finger and just smudge and blend the color in. I have put in a very light layer of color, so you'll see white spots in between the on the flower, but that's okay. Once we add another layer of color, they'll all get covered up. So I am really excited about using this medium. It's so easy and so quick for coloring. I did another alter new card with this recently, and I just absolutely love the result. So now I'm using an orange, and I'll add a little bit of shading to the petals. So I'm adding the orange only to the lower part of the petals in the flower, and then I'm again going to use my finger and just blend it a little bit. Now it is going to smudge, so the color is going to go outside the petal. Since I'm going to fuzzy cut these, I am not worried about that. But in case you are doing a one layer card, you might want to mask out the area near it and then color. So I'm going on with my third color here. I'm adding a bit of yellow only to the top of the petals this time instead of the bottom part, so that I have a little contrast and a little bit of shading in depth into the flower. And now you can see that those white spots are completely gone. The flower is completely filled up with color, and since it is on the textured side, it leaves really cool texture on the flowers, and I'm absolutely in awe of these colors. So I'll do the same thing with the petals and the stem. I'm using a lighter green first, and I'll just loosely color the flower, and then I'll go back in with a darker green and add a little bit of shading and depth to the stems and leaves. And while I'm working, while I'm coloring, I would just like to mention that Mudra Stamps also manufactures custom stamps. So if you have anything that you want to turn it into a stamp, you can always contact them. And I can assure you the quality is great, and they can really help you out with custom stamps. So that is another thing that you can look out for. So now I'm again blending with my finger here, the green color, and then I'll go back in with my darker green and add a little bit of dark color to the stem and to the center part of the leaves. I'm just following the guidelines on the stem basically, and then I'll just smudge it with my finger. Or rather, I would say I'd blend it with my finger. And you can see how well it blends. It smoothens out completely and leaves behind really cool texture and results. And I'm going to color. I haven't colored the second flower. I'm going to color the second flower offline. And when I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and take my scissor and fuzzy cut these out. Also, if you have a digital cutter, you can use the free SVG files that are available. Mudra is offering free files to cut these out digitally, which I think is really great. So now I'm working on the background. I chose to use two colors, blue and a bit of purple. And my initial idea was to use the stencil, use a baby wipe and stencil onto the background, but I think I chose the wrong stencil and it didn't work out as I had wanted it to. So then I decided to improvise and do a softer background instead. So I just took my baby wipe. The baby wipe is wet. Since the colors are water soluble, they are going to blend in and spread. I can easily blend them in and use them like watercolors. So as you can see, I'm just using the baby wipe and blending in that color on the background. So my idea is to keep the flowers, arrange the flowers on the side. And so I have colored my background accordingly. Now I'm stamping the sentiment. The sentiment says, wishing two people a wonderful life, one wonderful life, which is, I think, really cute for an engagement or a wedding card. And then I'm going to just arrange my flowers, and you can see that there are a few different possibilities. You could have them inverted, hanging down from the top, or you could have them on the side, you could have them from the center. I just wanted to show you a few different possibilities. Now to adhere them, I'm going to use some foam tape only on the flower, on the lower part of the flower, and I'll adhere the rest of the flower using liquid glue. This way I'll have the dimension on the flower, and you'll see what I mean in a minute. I'm going to just press down the bottom part so it looks like the flower is popped up from the base. And I'll do the same thing with my second flower, and I'm going to tuck it behind the first one, and I'll just pinch down the bottom part of this flower. And now I have the card almost ready. I'm going to just mount it on a white card base using some foam tape. And there you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you give Mudra Stamps a try. And please share with us. We have our Facebook group. We have our blog, Mudra blog. And please feel free to share your creations with us. And thank you so much for watching today. I hope you had fun. And I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.